This is Front Row on BBC Radio 4. The great American jazz saxophonist Charlie Parker, popularly known by the nickname Bird, died 65 years ago. So in the nature of things, there aren't many musicians around who knew and played with him. But my next guest, John Hendricks, did. Parker encouraged Hendricks to develop his unusual and to traditionalist controversial style of jazz singing, variously known as scat or vocalese. This technique reached a peak when in 1957 Hendricks joined Dave Lambert and Annie Ross in a trio specialising in intricate and often very rapid close harmony.
I was blue and I was always wearing a frown because my gal had turned me down. Then we met and you could tell I knew from the first you were my love, cause that's when the old gray now burst.
Cloudburst by Lambert, Hendricks and Ross. John Hendricks is in London to play some gigs and talk to me about his career and his memories of such contemporaries as Duke Ellington and Bird Parker. Some jazz musicians get through their careers without ever singing a word, but Hendricks explained language was in his blood.
My father was a minister in the African Methodist Episcopal Church, and he had 11 boys and 3 girls. 12 boys and 3 girls. We didn't count the girls enough. And I was the 9th child and the 7th son. And I was the most perspicacious when it came to reading and so forth. I was a good reader and I got A's in English. So he picked me at the age of 9 to go through the King James Bible for texts to his sermons that he wanted to preach that Sunday. And that led me to this book, the beautiful poetry in it, and the language in which it was written.
And the various terms that are used, scat singing and vocalese, do you think about that, or was it just a matter of following your instinct?
I just sang the song. I didn't give it a name or a style. I just did the song.
And so how would you do it? You'd start with the tune, and then what? Improvise, or?
I used to start with the tune, and then I was studying under my neighbor, Art Tatum. He would live 5 houses up the street from me in Toledo. And he was blind, and I was dumb. So he used to play things for me on the piano, and I'd just sing that. And he'd play me what I missed, and he's there like that. So how could this guy do all that? And it turns out, his mother told me the story, that she bought a piano roll for him, and she thought it would help him, and she gave it to him, and he learned it. And it was 2 guys. And he played both of them. He was incredible. So he was my mentor. So I have no boundaries.
And in the way that sometimes conventional singers, they'll say, I can't sing that or it doesn't suit my voice, could you scat anything
sure.
at all?
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. There are no limits to this thing we call the body. We can do anything. We're capable of anything. We just don't know what we're capable of, so what we do best first, we feel that's our forte. But a human being, I think, is a master of the earth and can do anything he wants. But his wants are small.
And when you were in the trio, the incredibly close harmony singing, which looks to people who don't sing, it looks very, very difficult. Is it?
Yes. It is difficult because of the songs that you have to sing.
Hey, you pick up what I say. Hard-head rabbit, but you keep yabbing. Your mama told you when you hop that if you stop, you cop the crop. He gets salty and gone for you because carrots and you take Americans too.
And in the trio, it's so slick when you listen to it now or watch it, and it's so fast sometimes, the number of words you're getting in. But that was rehearsal.
Yes. I would just do what I did. If I liked a song, I would sing it. And if there were no words, I would write the words.
Really is itching to see your face. Don't you meet him? Hide a hole in the fence. You can meet him with some natural sense. While he's over by the fence a while away. Keep on running till you're out of that gate.
I did take up the trombone once and knocked out my front teeth. Because I had no sense of embouchure. What was embouchure? What's this embouchure? What's an embouchure? So that was the last of my instrumental. Then I took up drums, because that was easy. You could just pick up the sticks and keep the rhythm. And so I played drums for 8 years until I got to New York at the invitation of Charlie Parker. And he came to Toledo where I was a student at the university. And I was studying law, and somebody told him that I was a scat singer. And so he invited me up to scat with him. And I came up. I was very afraid, you know, very scared. And I scatted three tunes. He said, "What you doing?" I said, "I'm studying law." He says, "Law?" I says, "Yeah." He says, "You ain't no lawyer." I said, "What am I then?" He says, "You're a jazz singer." I said, so what do I do about that? He says, "You got to come to New York." I said, "I don't know anybody in New York." He said, "You know me?" I said, "Well, I find you." And he said the most extraordinary thing. He said, "Just ask anybody." Mm-hmm. And I said, "What an egomaniac we got." And 4 years later, I went to New York, and they were playing, and he was soloing. And as I walked by, the most extraordinary thing, he was in the middle of... "Hey, John, how you doing, man? You want to sing something?" "Let's talk a little tease, a little pop, a little squeeze, a little try, a little sigh, a little maybe apply, a little bit.
I'm gonna tell you the truth, because I love you, and that's it. Because I love you, baby, love you, baby, love you, baby." You've also tried to do some education of the American people in jazz, that you tried to teach them more. You thought they didn't know enough about jazz.
Well, they don't have a ministry of culture. They don't have a ministry of culture because the people that gave jazz to the world were the slaves of their ancestors. And Barack Obama being so honored and praised by being America's first president, and we still having no ministry of culture. That's a disgrace.
Amazingly, and I would only have known this if I'd looked it up, you're 89.
I'm older than my mother.
I'm still performing. You obviously love it.
Oh yes, it's second nature to me. I wouldn't know what to do if I didn't have a place to sing. I'd go find one is what I would do. I would go sit in with somebody. I still do it because it's what I love to do most and what I do best.
John Hendricks is performing at Ronnie Scott's Club until Saturday as part of the London Jazz Festival.